Alright, so welcome YouTube. We're playing our Madcap experiment Scapeshift deck. Went 3-2 in the last league. Made a few little tweaks. Jeez, that's loud. Made a few little tweaks. And now we're ready to rock another league. So this hand's a little risky, because we already have one Empyrean in hand. I think we can do better. Because I think having Platinum Empyrean in your hand is kind of the same as mulling. What do you guys think, chat? Mull? Yeah, feels like a mull. That's definitely a better hand. Send search turn one, play explore. Ditch the path, because we don't have a way to find white right now. And hope that we don't need interaction in the matchup. Because we'll get to that Titan fast. Two explores. Oh, nice. I like what our opponent's playing already. Mountain into red spells. Yes, please. I guess we have to get stomping grounds just so that we keep our mountains up. Meow, Bonnie. You want to go on stream, Bonnie? You can go on stream. Come here. There you go, guys. There's Bonnie on stream. Meow. Meow. Yeah. Alright, let's go back to our matchup. Oop, I clicked on the wrong one again. So our opponent put a wayward guide beast into play and returned his land. Right, so we cast explore. Into Valakut. To bolt us down to 10. 3, 6, 9, yeah. I don't think he can kill us next turn. Angers are going to be good in this matchup. This gives us Titan here. So we have to find Forest for land 4, Castle Gardenburg land 5, and then we play our Titan. It's Titan time. Okay, so now the question is, we got two mountains in play. What do we do with the Titan? Get two more mountains, I think. Then he's not gonna have any way to deal with the Titan, and the next turn we can get, like, two Valakuts. Yeah. I guess we'll just get Sacred Foundry, Cinderglade. And Master Spy Forge with the entry to the $20 break credit for March. Using the 1,000 channel points. Congrats, congrats. Let me just write your name down. Why don't you say hi to us in chat or something, too? I saw you lurking earlier. Goblin grenade me. Well, that is lethal, unfortunately, guys. That was unfortunate. Goblin grenade, eh? Goblin grenade, huh? Anger of the gods. Obstinate Baloth. Cutting. One Titan. One Sakura. One Scapeshift. Yeah, maybe two Scapeshift. Or do we just trim all of our escape shifts and keep our Titan and Sakura in? Titan's faster than Sakura. If we could still get... Yeah, I like that. I like what I've done now. Keep the Sakura still over the Scapeshift. So we got four lands, explore, Sakura, platinum, madcap experiments, and a platinum Empyrean. We'll keep this. Keep this all day, every day against red. Oh no, we drew Empyrean. Can't draw Empyrean next turn. Yeah, I remember that. can't fetch with the Imperions. We'll use our fetch next turn. I guess we should have played our fetch here, because then we could have gotten our white source tapped. Would have been a little smarter, but... Our opponent sure is thinking. Hey, Master Spy, how's it going tonight? What are you up to? We don't need our white for life, so we'll just get Cinderglade. There we go. We're at 14 with Platinum Imperion. We should be safe. Crusaders of Memes. You like meme-y cards like Platinum Imperion? Maybe not today. And you can see it's the Platinum Imperion. Still like the sideboard plan, so we'll submit the deck again. Yeah, it's a good point. He might board into Braid, but I don't think that really... Like, even there, if he had played a Braid, he would have only attacked us for, like, five. And then we would have just untapped and probably gotten to play the second Madcap before dying. Plus, a Braid's also like a dead card in his hand every time we don't have Imperion, so that's fine with me. I think we keep this hand. Or do we try and mulligan for Platinum Imperion? The problem is we can't cast the path. It seems a little slower. Alright, well, chat's saying we should keep. Alright, we'll keep the double ramp and a way to get Titans good enough. Oh, right, because it thinks I want to cast Summoner's Pact at instant speed every single possible. time. There's our way to get white. No, wait, that's not a way to get white. We need red white. Opponent hasn't done much on turn two. Sorry, I don't have the whatchamacallit add-on that gives you the deck function. What is it called again? Stream Decker? Yeah, I don't think I set up my Stream Decker either, if I have Stream Decker. We should have moved the fetches around. Yeah, maybe we should have. That's probably a good point. Dryad's a very nice draw. We want to play Sakura because we want to block damage. We'll show off the deck list between rounds there. Don't worry. Four wooded and three windswept heaths. Well, I kind of like Sawyer's idea, four woodeds and three windswept heaths. Because then you can fetch your basic forests or your white color. And you can always fetch red off of it. It's better than the Misty, which doesn't do anything in our deck. The Misty was still there from Field of the Dead. Yeah, we just took a Field of the Dead list today and upgraded it, so Misty was better when Field of the Dead was legal. Also, my list was subpar for Field of the Dead because I didn't have a Verdant Catacombs in it. I had two Windswepts. I just never ended up buying the Verdant. Yeah, just a couple more tweaks between leagues. If it's only a land or two, that's nothing big. Also, not being able to play the path hasn't really made a huge difference. Honestly, I think if we had played the path, we'd be at less life. I just buy everything currently. I've considered using a rental service because it would allow me to play a much wider variety of decks. But I already own the cards for like 8 rack and a lot of combo decks that I like to play, so I already have a lot of stuff that I like to play. I just don't have access to a ton of things like Jun and Tron and Burn and all sorts of other meta decks. Gotta play the Bushwhacker Kickard. I've considered getting a rental service though for streaming. Might be a worthwhile expense, because then I could stream some different stuff too from time to time, but. Yeah. Well, I mean, I have the only deck I really care about playing much in Pioneer in Soul Built, so. So he gave his guys Trample. So we're just taking six. Well, that's a nice draw. Wipe his board. Yeah, that was a pretty good top deck. 3 for 1, while still being able to explore and ramp. That was a good play. Can't Goblin Grenade us this game, opponent, because you don't have a goblin in play. Do you use a rental service, Do you use a rental service, Freak, for your streaming, or, Yeah? What's it cost a month, and what's your, like, rental limit that you get on that? Where do you rent it from? Welcome, 100 Mana. Welcome to the channel. Why am I talking so slowly? I don't know. Maybe because my opponent's playing slowly. Hey Newton, sorry, we don't have the what's it called function for no stream decker here. I've been trying to get it set up, but something didn't work with it for some reason. We'll show you the deck list in just a moment after this game, though, so stay tuned for that. We're playing Madcap Experiment Scapeshift, which is a pretty spicy deck. 1, 2, 5, 6. So we can go to 5 and cast a Titan. I don't really want to take 2 damage, though. Is there a way we can do this better without taking damage? Compact for Baloth and play it slow. Did I bring my Baloth in? Yeah, I did. That's a good plan, actually. I kind of like that. Yeah, 100 or 850 ticks is pretty good. pretty good limit. Okay, so now we got a blocker, we got more life. We'll be able to path next turn after paying for our pact, and then we can Titan the turn after. We can maybe play the Dryad next turn or something, too, for the turn after. Oh, they don't have the man hours anymore, so you can return the cards and re-rent and stuff. That's good, that's good. Yeah, that's what I like. I'd like the ability to, like, be able to return the cards, take a 10-minute break, and play another league or something like that with a completely different deck if I was going to get a deck rental service. There we go, we can get our Dryad down too now. Yeah, I actually haven't done much playing off stream recently. I think I played like half a league off stream in the last month, if that. I don't know, I just figure if I'm gonna play, I might as well stream, but yeah, sometimes I play like 2 to 3 different decks in the same night, too. I got quite the arsenal of combo decks built up, at least. We're not attacking. We need blockers. Next turn we're just going to Titan and deal him 12, or Titan and clean his board. Oh yeah, Titan should wrap this game up. Like I said, we can Titan and deal him 12, or we could just Titan and clean up his board. Like, the best play he could do is Goblin Bushwhacker here, and then he gets 3 attackers through. Or a 1-drop, and then a Goblin Bushwhacker, and then he gets 4 attackers through. He's thinking really hard, though. Opponent's doing nothing. I like that. Well, he's still boldly attacking with everything. bolt me. Deal one. Don't tell me he has goblin grenade. Are you serious? Our opponent slow rolled that so long. If you say so. Could have blocked his two gobos in combat. And maybe played around goblin grenade, taking more damage. Gone to like. I feel like we misplayed that somehow. Huh. Alright, so apparently we are 0-1 now. That was a little bit of a shocker. Wow, we're up to 18 viewers apparently. Awesome, awesome. So if you guys are just tuning into the stream, you're dead to double bolt. Yeah, that's what I mean. I feel like our opponent had to, like, read us hard, and we had to read them hard to, like, beat them or something like that. I feel like there's a way to win that game. I really feel like there was. Your own one now. So this hand's pretty gas. We're gonna keep. We just need to find a way to win the game. Suspend search past the turn. I think our opponent's playing Death Shadow. Hey Barkman, my YouTube channel is FenglerMGG, same as it is on Twitch or Facebook. You can check out the YouTube channel FenglerMTG for all the replay videos of box breaks, pack cracks, gameplay. We're recording this league too. It'll be up on this channel later tonight. No problem. Thanks for tuning into the stream. How are you doing tonight, Barkman? Our opponent casts the ruse from his hand. Okay. I guess we're not playing Death Shadow. so we can escape shift next turn and kill him. Our opponent must be playing Death Shadow. Inquisition doesn't take escape shift. Thoughtseize does, though. Come on, Titaner Scape Shift off the top. Path. That would be good if we had a white source. So if we could draw a fetch, we could at least kill his Larus. 2, 4, 6, 7. We're one mana short of casting Imperion. So a land, a Titan, or a Scape Shift would be good. So that's most of our deck. Well, Summoner's Pact gets us Titan. 1, 2, 3, 4 mountains. Stubborn Denial. We have 8 mana for platinum with castle. Oh, good call, good call. Because it casts creature spells, right? Wait. To cast creature spells. No, we're good. Two, four, six, seven. That's Scape Shift for the win. So it's probably a Death Shadow deck. So our Veils are good. Our bailoff seems good too. Cause he's playing thought seizes and stuff. What do we not need? I think we can just cut the explorers because we have other redraws. Or cut three explorers. No, just cut four explorers because the veils are redraws. Yeah, we'll submit the list like that. All right, what's up, Twitch viewers? How's everyone doing tonight? Okay, this is a good hand, I think. Got a path to interact with these creatures, a dryad, a Baeloth, and a pact for the win. We'll keep. Plus, we're against the Thoughtseize deck, so we don't want to mulligan. Yeah, nobody expects the hard cast Empyrion, that's for sure. I think we'll just play Cinderglade tapped and save our life total for now. Tarmogoyf. We're just going to take 1 point. We'll path Larousse. Play our dryad out. We're not blocking, so we don't want to lose our guy to a bolt. going to try to counter this Baloth. It seems like a mistake. But okay. Three win cons. So I think we take 9 here. And he's gonna team her battle rage, his dude. Don't think we should have passed the ruse. I think that was our mistake. We'll submit the deck again. If we were on the play last game, we would have won. Alright, so we'll keep this hand. Gonna cycle his street race. Tarmogoyf, sure. I think we need a forest here. Alright, so he's got a counter spell, I think. So we'd rather run our experiment into it than our Titan. Disdainful stroke, delay. Sure. Hit us for 10. No, they wouldn't counter the pact. They would let the pact go. And then they would counter the Titan, and then we'd have to pay the upkeep cost on the pact. So we just get double mountain here. And deal him 12. And we win the game 2-1. Nice, nice. Puts us up to 1-1 in the league. 1-1 in the league. Awesome, awesome. Alright, so we're 1-1 now. Playing our Titan Shift Madcap Experiment deck. One dice roll, we'll play first. Okay, so we have Platinum Empyrean in hand, so it feels like a mulligan. So I think we're gonna mulligan. This hand's much better. We'll keep and get rid of the Misty. How's everyone in chat doing tonight? How's all our viewers doing? What are you guys up to? Are we against Grixis, Jeskai, something like that? Jeskai. Nice explore. Alright, let's see if this gets countered. Nope. Alright. Alright, so now we're starting to bolt the opponent down. It's a very good setup against control, because I can't do much to stop it. So in response, we'll sack this for a mountain. Get a Valakut trigger. And then we'll use Path's ability to get a mountain and get another Valakut trigger. Summoner's Pact into Titan. This is gonna get countered. No. So we get a Valakut and a mountain, deal him 6. think the opponent's dead. They gotta kill our Titan, and then if we draw land, we still kill them. Is your opponent disconnected? I don't know. What's everybody in chat saying tonight? Who's all watching still? 7 viewers with us. Awesome, awesome. Alright, so here's Bonnie sleeping on the stream. And for everybody who's just joining us tonight, be sure to hit that follow button. Somebody on our followers list is going to win this Expedition Celestial Colonnade in the next few days. As well, consider subbing to the channel. Get use of all of our emotes. We're making the big push to go from 35 to 50 subs by the end of the month. So the next 15 subs get a 50-50 chance to win a booster pack. If you gift someone a sub, you get a 50-50 chance to win a booster pack still. The next 15 subs or sub gifters will be entered into a draw to win the Kaldheim promo pack. And if we reach our goal of getting to 50 subs, one of our subs is going to get this Kaldheim collector's pack at the end of the month, raffled off to them. Or as soon as we get to 50 subs, either way. Okay, our opponent conceded. We're playing against some sort of Jeskai control deck. And I'm not really sure what's good. Path to Exiles don't seem good. Rest in Peace does seem good. I don't know. Not really a huge change. They played like no creatures in the first half of their deck, and it seems like they wanted to like use their graveyard by thought scouring themselves. It's a bit slow for hand, but I think we can keep it. Nice top deck forest. Aggressively cleansing, wildfiring our forest. Titan, not a bad draw. Get a mountain. Madcap experiment. Gonna path our dude, sure. Three, four, five. I think we just cast the Titan first. Two. Go find all of our Valakuts. Now we're at 5 mountains, 3 Valakuts. So we should be able to kill him pretty fast. Well, next turn we can play our Valakut attack with our Titan and do him 24 with the land triggers.
opt again. And we win the match. Easy game over control. So we're now 2-1 in the league. 2-1 in the league. Alright, so we're 2-1 now. Playing our Scapeshift Madcap Imperion deck. Let's see, this hand has 3 lands, some searches, a Titan, and a Scapeshift. That's pretty good. Fortunately, we're on the draw. All right, we're playing against Dredge again. Conserve a bit of life total. Our opponent got a Stinkweed Imp. And then they got a Conflagrate. Meow, Bonnie. So you can flag-rated me for 3. That seems a little odd. I guess he really wanted his Stinkweed Imp back in the graveyard. To do suspend search. Amoeba triggers prized amalgam. Can also just escape that ox.
Okay, we drew Platinum Empyrean. It's not very helpful. We're gonna take 6, 7, 8, 9. We need a blocker. Gotta get the Dryad. I don't know if we're winning game one here. So I think we're dead with Creeping Shell. Yeah, we're dead. Alright, so cards that are really good here. Rest in Peace. Anger of the Gods. Maybe the Baloth. Cut two of the Scapeshifts, one of the Titans. One of the Dryads and two Explorers. Submit deck. Yeah, we'll play first. It's got double Rest in Peace, one mana. Mulligan. Anger of the Gods, times two. That seems pretty good. I'm just going to get rid of the pact. Keep two angers. Two angers should be enough to win the game. If not, we'll figure out how to win after that.
Big boy Bailoth showing up. Opponent didn't get much off his first big dredge. We'll sack the Sakura. Cast Anger of the Gods. Exile everything in play. That's 5 mountains now. So every mountain's a bolt, and we got an Anger of the Gods still to exile his next big board state. Meow. Double Creeping Chill, sure. Probably gonna bring back the ox again. No, he's gonna life from the loam, fill his hand up, frickin' fly great. Good thing we got this bail off. Actually, we're at 4, and then with the Bailoth, we're at 8, so we're just dead. Damn it. Life from the Loam, go to 8, play a land. Kill us for 7. Twice now we've died to exactly lethal. Well, this game we could have like won with a scape shift or something. Alright, so we're 2-2 now in our league. 2-2. Oops, sorry, I missed the start of the match with the recording. We're 2-2. Trying to win that treasure chest. What do we got coming here? Supreme Verdict. Sure. Get 2 Valakuts. We have 5 mountains and 2 Valakuts now, so every mountain's a 2 Valakut triggers, which is 6 damage to them. Ooh, Platinum Empyrean. Too bad we couldn't hard cast that sucker. Actually, let's kill Teferi and deal 3 to him. Cleansing Wildfire's ability. Next turn Platinum? Yeah, probably. Hey, sorry, we don't have the stream deck or add-on. I'll show you the deck list between games here. Thanks for tuning into the stream, Anquinor. If you haven't already hit that follow button, definitely should do that. We're giving away a Celestial Colonnade Expedition to one of our followers in the next couple days. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I guess. He lets it resolve, okay. I guess he's got a way to deal with it. Teferi tuck it.
cast our explore to redraw. Bolt to ferry. Play this Platinum Imperion again. Play a land for turn. Bolt him. Oh, we were supposed to fetch before we played the Platinum Imperion. What's he gonna do about the Platinum Imperion? Titan and win the game. Alright, so Arknor, here's our deck list on screen. We're gonna make some sideboards in a second. Alright, awesome. Have a good night, Sawyer. Thanks for tuning in, as always. So, don't have a lot to change here. Just changing the paths for rest in pieces.
So we have Platinum Empyrean in our opening hand, so that's kind of like a mulligan. So we're going to mulligan. This hand's way more gas. Just bottom the Valakut. Who else is still watching us on the stream tonight? 12 viewers, awesome, awesome. If you guys are just joining the stream, feel free to hit that follow button. All the followers are going to be entered into a draw in the next couple of days for an Expedition Celestial Colonnade. I feel like he's got a counter spell here ready. So I think we're just gonna play the Sakura. Yeah, Sakura is our third best two drop right now, so that's why we played it into the counter spell. Cast Explore, cast Rest in Peace. Should be pretty good. Fate sealing me. Puts a card on top. Madcap Experiment. Okay, so I guess he has no problem with us casting Madcap Experiment. Oh, we should have cracked our fetch first. That was a misplay. I just get bounce the Empyrean onto our hand. Cast this Primeval Titan, which will probably get countered.
cryptic command, sure. Try to cast Madcap. Draws out a counter. Play a land for turn. If we draw a land, we can Platinum Imperion next turn. Don't know how good that is against three Planeswalkers and a mitt full of cards, but I think we're just dead. Ambush Viper. He's trying to kill us. He's just gonna bounce it with little Teferi though. Last chance to win. still seems like good boarding. Keep. How's everybody in chat doing tonight? What are you guys saying? What do you think of the deck list? So 100% this Titan's getting countered. Cryptic counter draw. Play another Titan then. We'll top that. Guess we'll fire off the Titan again. Since we know it's gonna get countered. Snapcaster Cryptic. Time for Platinum Empyrean. Well, it did not get countered. Interesting.
Guess he has another way of dealing with it. I think he's out of counter spells. I sure hope he's out of counter spells. Alright, so we win the match. Winning the league 3-2. Our second 3-2 of the night. Deck feels pretty good. Thanks for tuning in, YouTube. If you guys enjoyed the content, feel free to like the video or subscribe to the YouTube channel. If you want to get in on the live action, FenglerMTG on Twitch or FenglerMTG on Facebook. Notifications when I'm going live and such. We stream most nights, box breaks, pack cracks, modern, stuff like that. Pretty exciting time. Thanks for tuning in, YouTube, and have a good night.